Hey guys, Jessica from the future. I got so excited about telling about this project that I forgot to tell you what it's about. I'm on a mission to show the world that disability doesn't mean inability, and we're building the impossible airplane, the first ever airplane that can be flown with just feet. We had to start somewhere. I know nothing about building. I know nothing about sheet metal work, riveting, all that whole thing that it takes to build an airplane. So we were happy when Van sent us a practice kit. It's basically my first ever toolkit. I'm excited because this is the future of the first ever impossible airplane, an airplane that can be designed to be flown with feet.
We're on a traffic up to 105. We're 2 miles of final for 1 kilometer traffic.
We are officially starting this whole project. You know, we announced it to the world, but I feel like today when we drive up to Safford, Arizona, so that tomorrow morning, super early in the morning, we can meet with Chandler, who's gonna help us with some of the sheet metal work to do some of the practice kits that was sent to us by bands.
Hey, good morning.
Hey, good morning.
How are you?
Good, how are you guys?
Good.
I basically started off by Googling what does sheet metal work entail. I started off by just finding out some of the things that I needed to get. So I have the first aid kit here in front of me. I got a hard hat, safety goggles, made sure I had closed toe shoes. I even have a headset, basically if it gets too noisy. And it's all packed away here along with some foot gloves in case it requires that. I have no idea, so I just figured to be more prepared. So I'm set with all the stuff. And we're ready to start this project, Project 2025. I'm excited to go out there to Safford to hang out with Chandler. Just so that all of you know, Chandler is an amazing kid. I mean, he's young. I think he must be under 20, but he has personally been a part of building like a 10 or 15 airplanes, and these are RVs. I will find out tomorrow exactly what the number is, but it's pretty incredible to hang out with such a someone who's so young and yet so passionate about building planes. And to be there in Safford, where he was a part of building some other airplanes, is going to be exciting, just to be able to see where he did all of this building. Just kind of learn a couple pointers about riveting from him and doing sheet metal work.
As with anything, before you start on any project, any new section or whatever, I always go through, read the entire section. Anytime there's like a note or anything like that that's in bold, I'll take a highlighter and I'll actually highlight it, because then I'll remember like, okay, there's something special or unique about what's going on here. This seems pretty straightforward, so obviously we'll just take a look at the plans really quick and make sure we know what's going on, and then we'll kind of go from there.
I'll be completely honest, I'm not that excited about a sheet metal day, but I'm gonna just give it a try, stretch myself, and see what it's like to attempt to do this with my feet.
It looks a lot easier than it feels when you hold onto the part. You gotta have a pretty good grip, because that the machinery basically is pretty darn strong at filing it down.
Right out here.
So I don't have one of these tools at home. Or at the hangar. So thanks to Chandler for lending us his. But if any of you have one that you can donate, I'd appreciate it. Or if you have ideas of how we can modify it so it's easier to use with my feet. Got it.
People are afraid of when they think about this concept of building a plane. It's like, are you sure you trust whoever's building the plane? Because you don't want it to fall apart mid-flight. And I realize now from this experience that everything is so detailed, so meticulous, that it is very thought out. We are very careful from building every little piece of the airplane. And so I think this has given me a lot of trust in aviation and experimental builds.
That's what a Clico is.
This is a Clico.
Oh, Clico?
Clico.
Clico.
C-L-E-C-O. All it is it's a placeholder for a rivet or a bolt or a screw. There's different sizes as well. The majority of what we'll use will be 40s, but you also use a lot of 30s depending on the assembly you're building.
This is not called riveting, is it?
This is not riveting. This is clicoing. You can.
Okay.
And then these are just clico pliers. So it's a fairly stiff spring. And you have
to hold it together, have a little tension.
Yeah. And then we'll go in this hole right down here.
Yeah, oh, next I scratched one it already.
And then pinch them together.
Pinch them together?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because you have to depress the spring. So squeeze, 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 squeeze.
Good.
Yeah, it won't go in unless it's depressed anyways.
I need to depress it better. Oh, I see. You have to depress it to get it in.
Yep.
Come on. Sorry, it'll.
Oh, you're close. No, you're good.
Come on. Okay, thank you.
All right, so go ahead and let it go. There you go.
Okay.
Just like that. And then you can let it go.
Let it go. It comes off.
And then it comes
off. Nice. That felt a little different because of the fact that I had to depress on the little device in order to put the clico in. And I was pressing as hard as I could, but I had to have precision at the same time because I had to be right in the hole at the exact same time. And then what was even stranger is that once it's in the hole, you actually just let go of it and it's in. And it just felt weird to let go of the tool. Again, if you have other modification ideas for how to do this clicoing, let me know in the comments. Thanks.
This will be an example of some of the riveting we would do for the real airplane kit. But right now, again, this is just a practice kit, so we can make as many mistakes, and I'm relieved with that. Now that I think about it, I have tried my foot at welding, and that was in Manhattan, Kansas at a university, but I've never done anything with sheet metal. So this is gonna be a first for me.
Jessica's first shop head, right there.
First of what, how many million we're gonna have to do.
Okay, ready? Nice. What do you think, Chu? Is she doing good? Yeah?
So did we dimple the wrong side on
the board?
I
dimpled to the wrong side. Now.
Oh. So the great Chandler dimpled the wrong side?
Yes, I did.
A little lesson on how you should mark your parts. Well, you just had some extra work, unnecessary work that Chandler had to do is that called redimpling it? Redimple the part because we forgot to mark them ahead of time.
I forgot to mark them ahead of time.
Well, it's a lesson learned. Very important lesson learned.
Yeah, important lesson learned. Right now I have it set up ready to go. These are called dimple dies. I make several different kinds of them. These are just your regular standard dimple dies that you can buy off yard store or wherever. The trigger, and it'll form our nice pretty dimples. And then continue on.
This part is gonna take a lot of serious modification, but I already have some ideas. So if you wanna check out the website, there's a link below. It will bring you to the build website and you can kind of see those ideas that were sent in.
We're going to be out in the hangar that doesn't have air conditioning in Safford, Arizona. I know it is a couple degrees cooler in Safford than it is in Tucson, but I'm gonna have to get over it. We're gonna go out at a really early hour, so hopefully it's not too hot, and try to our best to manage the heat and try our hand or my foot at sheet metal work and riveting.
Toolbox.
Yeah,
I know.
Too bad.
Awesome.
Head up top, that, ta-da.
I am admiring the rivets because that is obviously what today was about, was learning about riveting and really just kind of seeing what it's all about to put an airplane together, which is pretty incredible. And I'm here with Chandler. He has done, what were you telling me, like 20 airplanes?
Yeah, probably around 20 airplanes now. All RVs, yeah.
And he was basically not even 21 when that all happened, right? I know you're 21 now and you're building another RV,
yep.
Right?
Working on another 14, yep.
Pretty incredible for your young age. And I think that it was awesome that you were teaching us today all about the riveting process, all about how we can start this and just launch this project today with this toolkit as a finished product.
Yep, pretty exciting stuff. I think a lot of good lessons were learned, myself included. Thank you guys for coming and having me. It was a lot of fun putting this together with you guys. If you guys ever have more questions, you can look me up on Facebook. Just search Chandler Webb. I'm there. I'm pretty active on Facebook. I also have a YouTube channel. You can just go to YouTube, search Chandler Webb. I'm also there. Arizona Sport Planes does have a website. It's a little bit older, but you can check us out there. I think there's a cell phone number on that you can call that you can get a hold of us. And again, it was just really nice having you guys here.
Thank you. I know we're boiling over here. It's a 99 degree day in Arizona, but it was well worth the day hanging out with Chandler. Thanks for coming and following along with us on this. If you want to find out more about our build, we're going to have a website very soon. It may not be up just yet, but be sure to check it out. In the description is a link. Otherwise, follow us on YouTube and of course, give us a like and subscribe because we need that. We also need tools. So if you think you can help donate to this project and help us get us tools or help fund us because it is gonna be expensive, please again, go to the link below and click on that and follow us. Thank you so much. Take care.